Good evening and welcome to the NBA on TNT. And by that I mean the North America Duo Tournament. It's another Saturday night. We're bringing you the one and only match today. It's going to be Shake Inc. versus Speed Frog. Losers bracket round six matchup. MLOK Happy versus Exarch and Fleslin for a spot in the losers bracket round seven. And with it, of course, in the top. Some number of other teams. I am this one guy, and I'm going to be joined by no one. But thank you for the host, anyway, for the raid. I'm going to be joined by myself, me, myself, and I, for tonight's matchup of two teams that I think should make for an interesting stylistic matchup. I think you've got some very mechanics players in this one, as we've seen out of MLOK Happy, Exarch Fleslin likewise. Very mechanics-heavy matchup that I think will be an interesting one to see. We kind of saw MLOK Happy get banned out a little bit last week against Aryu and Fancy Lad. We'll see if Exarch and Fleslin can do the same sort of thing, or if the former pair can overcome what can occur to them into matchups where they get forced into playing matches and maps that they don't really like quite as much. You know, guys that more into those streams, more into the aim, a little less so into some of the reading type of picks, less so into the little gimmick type of maps. Exarch and Fleslin, as I said, you know, also going to be some very good aim players, solid with the precision, pretty decent with speed. They've relied on Exarch to carry certain maps within that skill set quite a bit. I think probably the more well-rounded of the two, but Fleslin definitely coming in with his aim moments and winning some points for that roster. MLOK Happy, you know, you get a lot out of both these guys, I think, in terms of skill cap. You know, both players who are very solid with those mechanical skill ceilings. But we'll see what they can do in this matchup. I think this one is a little bit of a more favorable on paper than last week, but I think it's still going to be a tricky one as we get deeper and deeper into this tournament. The map pools continue to get harder and harder. Starting things off with the little Vaxe warm-up. I don't know how people hit this, actually. I mean, nobody in this lobby hitting the thing, but we're watching Vaxe's play on this. The amount of those back-and-forth jumps he hit is, like, actually unreal. We see most players not having a very good time with this, unsurprisingly. C ranks are across the board at the first break. Of course, these teams taking slightly different paths to get here this week. This will be the first match for Team Shake Inc. in the loser's bracket, as I was discussing, and they did drop down to Team White Cat last week. Aryu and Fancy Lad, I would, you know, say the overwhelming favorites to win this tournament. I don't really know that anybody stands much of a chance to stop them. We'll see tomorrow as they face off against Fiery and Beast Troll. Those are really the only ones that I could see having much of a chance at taking a significant advantage on really any type of maps. Just the raw skill and experience of those two in tournaments, really, really high. But, you know, Fancy Lad playing some of the best Osu of anyone in the world in the tournament scene right now. And, of course, Aryu up there with him as an incredibly well-rounded partner. So, not a big surprise to see Shake Inc. dropping to them last week. They did have solid wins previous to that over back-to-back Washington teams. Of course, Greg Washington, round of 16, and Washington in quarterfinals after taking out Rushia Fan Club in the round of 32. On the other side, you know, Speed Frog also faced one of those top two seeds. Unfortunately, theirs was a round earlier in the quarterfinals. They were dropped to the loser's bracket by the Unnation. That is, of course, Fiery and Beast Troll. Took out Zudi and Kyle on Team Slijovica previously to that. And then last week, of course, their losers bracket debut defeated Nanahira Method Woey and his teammate, whose name I'm not looking it up, so I don't know offhand who's his teammate, the hidden player. Was it Trailmix? Was that the Trailmix team? I think that was the Trailmix team. And then, of course, eliminating the team named after me, eliminated team this one guy, Chillier Pair and Riot. So that set up this loser's bracket round six matchup. Down to the top six teams remaining in the tournament. I think, three of them are absolutely no surprise at all. Fancy Lad Airu, Beast Troll, Fiery, and then TJ Nutami. Maybe surprising to some who aren't familiar with how solid they are in tournaments, but Team Midnight Snow has been looking pretty solid. Also dropped down last week in the semifinals at the hands of Fiery and BTMC. Well, of course, you have Team Leebs as their opponent, which I don't really think anybody saw that one coming. I don't know that there's many people who would have looked at the tournament here and said, yeah, Headstack and Mode are going to be top six in this tournament. Vastly overperforming expectations for them. And then, of course, this matchup, the other two teams remaining. So, very interesting, diverse cast of characters in this finals weekend here. We get to see the last six teams. We'll be eliminating two of them here. One of them tonight, one of them tomorrow. We'll take us down to the top four. Which, I'm liking Midnight Snow, and I'm liking... I think I'm liking Team White Cat. And then, our third elimination, of course, will come at the end of the night tomorrow, leaving us with the top three. I think, that one is going to be a very tight one to try and predict. The winners of Midnight Snow and Leebs taking on the winner of Shake Ink and Speed Frog. That one impossible to call. I don't even know who's going to win the first matchups. I think Midnight Snow wins. I think Speed Frog might win this, but I think Shake Ink definitely can win this. And then that matchup tomorrow, Midnight Snow or Leebs. I mean, any of those four teams can win, so we'll have to get there. And we're coming in to the second warm-up here, getting some Taylor Swift. I don't know who picked this, because I don't know who in this knows that I adore Taylor Swift. But if you haven't listened to her new album out about a week ago on Spotify and all their major streaming platforms, Evermore, continuing in the vein of Folklore, very much a spiritual successor to that album, and every bit as high quality. Highly recommended to anyone who enjoys the musical stylings of Taylor. I don't know that I've ever seen this map played without DT. This is a first, because I have only ever played it DT myself. But these guys just want to enjoy the song. They're here to vibe to the music. So I think, of course, the big matchup that everybody's waiting for this week is going to be that winner's final. I was really was hoping that was going to be tonight. That would have been a nice Saturday evening feature match. But unfortunately, the boys in that matchup decided at the 11th hour. Nope, just kidding. Fuck you guys in your stream schedule. Oh, Exarch with the 100. This isn't even the top diff of this set, I'm pretty sure. This is like the second diff. This is the lowest diff. This is 1.61 stars. The top diff is the dancing diff, which I am the proud owner of a 1x100 FC with DT on for the whopping total of 246 PP. Thank you very much. Truly an up-and-coming talent. So we're chilling, listening to some Taylor. Oh, actually, it is me. I'm drop frames 0%. I have a little red thing. Why is my thing red? How do I make my thing not red? Send help. How do I make my thing not red? Okay, I think we're maybe good? I'm not sure. My bitrate is just fluctuating all over the place and I don't know why. My bitrate is actually just like doing the weirdest shit right now. Right, it just ended. It just ended. Okay, we're back. That was weird. Well, I'm 0% drop frames, so I'm gonna say it's okay. The quality might be kind of iffy, but 0% drop frames, so. Yeah. Anyway, we are going to roll onward into the band phase. Exarch winning the roll. We'll have first band, second pick in the match. Hero at the top left corner. Map pool. We're gonna get rid of it before anybody's. And I think this is gonna be probably the same bands as Fancy Ariu in this matchup. It's just Nomad 2, Nomad 5. What's up? Hey Man does get banned. The Cappy song is banned against Cappy. You hate to see it. You truly hate to see it. That is an unlucky Osu movement. Not overly surprising, though. That is something that Emelon and Cappy are both extremely talented in the Nomad 2 bracket, so memes aside, I think it's perfectly logical to ban out Nomad 2s against them. It's a little troll because it is a Cappy meme song, but what are you gonna do? Can't avoid banning a map just because the other team is part of the song. And to the surprise of no one, Shake Ink gonna come back with a hidden 2 ban. They're not reading players, so they ban the LBR6 hidden pick. Just standard. I wouldn't honestly be overly surprised if they just double ban hidden, because they are not great at it. Unless one of the two remaining hidden picks, Cappy, feels like he can do quite well, and I don't think MLA will be super into either. But that is going to be Yuki Dosuke Yasha. Is that right? Yuki Dosuke. That's actually the word. Yuki Dosuke. Huh. And there is the Nomad 5 ban. Hails from the Edge. Warcry difficulty. That is, of course, the LMT Nomad 5. But we see Grand Finals. Map pool pick. So the same bands against Shaking, week in and week out. Get the Nomad 2 ban, get the Nomad 5 ban. We want to remove that speed and stream advantage from their team. You know, and this is kind of the interesting strategic aspect of the ban phase. You know, Exarch and Fluzzlin banning out their opponent's strengths. Meanwhile, Shake Ink looking like they're going to be kind of banning out their own weaknesses instead. Getting rid of Hidden 2, not reading players. Going to get rid of DT4 as well. That is Haruno Yuki. Hand of Heroes Insane. So that's one of the DTs, obviously. Double time number 4. That is an AR 10.3. Decently high BPM, of course. 330 BPM. Quite high BPM. I don't know. Do I have to restart? Like, the bitrate is fine, but the thing is red. Pardon the typing sounds. While we're waiting on the first pick from Speed Frog, I'm gonna try to troubleshoot this real quick. Or if there is any way to troubleshoot this, I don't know if there is. It's gonna be Hard Rock 1 as the first pick from Speed Frog, so. The It song slash map is going to be coming in. It is the end. Embodiment of all your worst fears. 7-star Hard Rock 1. My internet's just shitting the bed right now, actually. It's at like 1/3 its normal speed. And I don't know why. I have half of my normal upload speed and 1/3 of my normal download speed. And it's literally the Twitch Chicago server, so I can't be any closer, you know what I mean? Like, that's couple hundred miles away at most. I'm gonna leave it for this map and hope that it at least plays through this map, because the funny thing is I'm not dropping any frames. We're gonna play through this map and then just try to sort it out in between. So it is map number one. First pick from Speed. No, excuse me. First pick from. First pick from Shake Inc. Aim Hard Rock, no big surprise there to see them selected that option. Has some streams, has a lot of aim. A little bit of uncomfortable patterning here and there, but nothing overly crazy. And both Cappy and Fluzzling gonna find an early break while Exarch and Emwa hold on through the intro. And Fuzzling trading once again. It's all on Exarch and Emlock currently. Cappy with a little bit of an accuracy lead over Fuzzling, but otherwise this one's basically dead even. There's another break from Cappy, so small combo lead to Speed Frog. Not a big one though. It's all gonna be in the big jumps in his key eyes, and there goes Emlock. Exarch holds on. Let's see how big of a combo advantage he can build up here. That's a lot of lead for Speed Frog in terms of both combo and a bit of accuracy on Exarch's part. This is, I feel like, where just the experience of Exarch is so important. Emla, obviously an incredibly high mechanical skill cap player, as Exarch does find a break, so it's combo lead disintegrated now, but Exarch just, you know, he's able to keep things pretty steady most of the time. However, let's find those couple of breaks. We'll see if he can bring it back together here. It's going to be a little bit of advantage. Now a lot of an advantage for Shake Inc. Fuzzling falling to pieces there, and Exarch and Fuzzling now have really no combo at all to speak of. Fortunately for them, Cappy's struggling a little bit, but Emla has regained some combo. Not anymore, though. So that is a full combo reset. No combo on anyone. That's good for Speed Frog, bad for Shake Inc. Into some more big jumps in this Ki. And it is just going to be even so far through this portion. A little bit of a combo lead for Speed Frog. Still a third of the map to go, and it's only about a 40,000 point gap between the teams. Another break from Cappy. He is not having the best of time on this map. You got to think this is maybe picked with the intentions of having Emla try to carry it in mind as Cappy continues to struggle. But Exarch and Fluzzlin both putting together some pretty decent combo through that quarter of the map. And they will now come into the final quarter of the map with about an 80,000 point lead. The first serious lead that this map has seen for either team. Emla with a 300 combo, but he's matched by both Exarch and Fluzzlin. Cappy down at 100 combo and pretty far behind on score as well. And into the ending we're going to go. And it looks like Speedfrog is just going to be able to hold on to this one. A miss aim from Exarch, but it is traded by Cappy. And there goes Emla as well. That's going to decide it. That's going to seal map number one. We're going to see a very early break point here for Speedfrog. Not the greatest pick in the world from Shake Inc. I think decent on paper, but unfortunately their performance just did not bear it out. Exarch with about a 485k, Fluzzlin 324k. Just both outperforming their opposition by a pretty similar amount. It ends up being a 60,000 point victory for Team Speedfrog, and you can see 30,000 of that on both players. Both doing their part despite the lower accuracy from Fluzzlin. That's going to be Speedfrog with the 1-0 lead. And hopefully things are back to normal. My little square is green now instead of red. So hopefully it'll be better on the viewer end as well. It's like the bitrate issues may have been fixed. I don't want to speak too soon. I don't want to jinx myself, but it seems as though they may have had a little bit of a fix. First pick for Speedfrog, gonna be unsurprisingly a hidden selection. This goes well. You can, I think, expect to see them go heavily into the hidden and reading sorts of skill sets in this matchup because it does seem like the place that they're gonna be favored. You saw Shake Inc. ban out the hidden. Now, granted, they banned out, you know, that kind of hidden reading slot, the AR8 CS5 hidden pick, but hidden in general, something that Exarch is going to be kind of the one player in this lobby who's really comfortable with. We have seen some of these matches start up with several breakpoints. It's not the rarest type of thing to get a couple early breakpoints. And I now can't watch my own stream because Twitch is giving me the purple thing. So they have patched another ad block. Nice. Another one. Holy shit, these guys are on a fucking war. Just all in on war. Unbelievable. Alright, anyway. Into the hidden one pick we are gonna go. Ananiameo Kimi ni Utao. Collab between everybody's favorite square mappers, Miresh and Shirohamamami, aka Delis. And you can see, starting off not the greatest already, several breaks in the intro. It seems like Fluzzlin is going to be the hidden gamer here this time. I apologize to him for not realizing that he was going to be the gamer. Very early on, of course, this is the longest map, one of the longest maps in the pool, 4 minutes 12 seconds. A lot of time in this one. A little bit of early combo lead in favor of Speedfrog. Exarch slightly ahead of Cappy's combo, and Fluzzlin the only FC left in the intro. You know, it feels like on maps like this, you kind of know what you're getting into. When you see a Mirage or a Delis hidden pick, you know, it's going to be kind of that, you know, kind of dense aim, often slightly awkward hidden type of pick. You're seeing the effects of that here as Exarch and Emla trade a couple breaks in this first key eye. Happy holding on to some combo, trying to match Flezzlin as best he can. He will now go ahead of Flezzlin, who finds a break, but his combo is immediately gone. Four-way combo reset in the key eye here. Low aim in combination with kind of awkward aim through these somewhat tricky slider and linear patterns, tripping up all four of the players a couple of times. So for now, we combo advantage back in favor of Speed Frog, Exarch, and Emla trade breaks. Flezzlin a little bit ahead of Cappy. About a 60,000 point lead. Speed Frog gonna try to run with that as best they can. They get a little bit of room to rest here. The second verse comes in. There's a little bit of freer combo. These key eyes are, of course, the tricky spots, as to be expected. See what kind of combo advantage they can build up. Exarch about 90 combo ahead of Emlaw. Flezzlin only about 15 combo ahead of Cappy. Those two staying very close together, but Flezzlin with a little bit of a score lead. 20,000 is all though. And into the next key I will go. Let's see who can hold. Emlaw immediately breaking, so that's going to be a bit of free combo now for Exarch. There goes Cappy also. This one's going to be falling by the wayside pretty quickly for Shake Ink. Speed Frog looking quite good once again here, looking much more comfortable in this second key eye, though Flezzlin does eventually find a break. But Speed Frog, clearly the more comfortable team on this pick so far through this map. About a two-thirds through, Exarch combo is now gone, but it's combo reset as both players from Shake Ink miss as well. And Flezzlin carries some combo through that difficult section. Top score in the lobby by a decent margin, about 60,000 points. Emla struggling, unable to get even to 200,000 points as of yet. Obviously a very tricky map, but falling pretty far behind the others. Just into the last key eye with a full combo reset once again. So this is going to be Speed Frog taking their own first pick. They'll consolidate on that first break point. It'll be an early 2-0 lead by margin of around 200,000 points, it looks like, by the time this is all said and done. Hidden skill and aim ability just coming in pretty strong here for Speed Frog. Obviously nobody putting up an incredibly overpowering single performance. Really just the team skill playing out here for Speed Frog, allowing them the victory on this pick. That's exactly what you'd like to do if you're starting off this match. You get a map that is a decent pick for both teams and win it, and you get a map that is in your favor and win it as well by a couple hundred thousand points. That's exactly what Speed Frog wanted to get going here. Not what Shake Ink would like to see, but they've got a long way to go here. This is a best of 13, so the 2-0 lead is not going to be too fearful to see. You're going to feel, you know, not perfect, obviously, but it's not the end of the world. Plenty of time left, 5 points from the finish line for Speed Frog, but Shake Ink definitely going to want to look a little better on their next pick. I think they're going to want to find another map that hopefully they can feel. And try to run with that and get on the board here. And now we await the second pick. And it's going to be a free mod pick here for Shake Ink. It's going to be free mod number 2. I want Gate Eye, Gate Odyssey Mix Challenge Difficulty. This is like actually just incorrect metadata, I'm fairly sure. I don't think there's any way that metadata is accurate. There's an open parenthesis with no matching closed parenthesis. big question mark on that one. But an interesting pick here for Shake Ink. However, I will note that they picked a similar map last week, Freemod 2 last week, also in small circle, low AR Freemod. And they won that against Aereo and Fancy Lot. And so they're going for it again here. It's going to be CS4.2 Air 8.6 for this one. See how it goes here for Shake Inc. looking to get on the board. Here we are. Emla Hard Rock, Cappy Hidden, Exarch, and Fluzzlin both Hard Rock. So everybody opting into the slightly smaller circle Hard Rock on this pick, other than Cappy on low AR Hidden. An early break from Emla right at the beginning as well, followed up by Cappy shortly thereafter. Exarch and Fluzzlin both holding through the first 100 combo before Fluzzlin broke. This is another one of those, I think, pretty tricky mechanical types of picks, despite it being more focused on finger control and slider aim than kind of raw aim. Plenty of streams to be had here. Exarch making it look easy. Over 99% accuracy, still holding on to the FC. Doing a bit of a lead here to Speedfrog, but it's going to remain decently close for now as he does find a break, trades with Cappy. Fluzzlin with the combo lead over Emla loses it with his own break. So let's see how long Emla can hold on here. See if he can bring some of this score gap back. Already about 50,000 points, but that's going to drop pretty quickly. 400 combo, that's a pretty sizable advantage over everyone else. How long can he maintain this combo? That's going to be the big question. It's going to bring the score back a ways, but not all the ways. There goes the miss. Happy with the 250 combo, but Exarch hot on his heels and Fluzzlin not far behind them either. Speedfrog going to take that lead. Back out once again, over 30,000 points. Fluzzlin with the break, but Exarch holding on strong. About halfway through, and there's a 60,000 point lead in favor of Speedfrog. Double break point would be pretty demoralizing, I think, early on here for Shake Inc. Speedfrog looking very consistent on these early maps. As I said, they've got a long way to go no matter the outcome of this pick, but they'd feel pretty good if they can get two break points in the first two picks from Shake Inc. here. That kind of momentum just feels very good emotionally. If you're a mental kind of player, one who excels in the lead and perhaps struggles from behind. Good spot to be in. I think if you're Speedfrog, you know, no matter what, you just want to keep playing good OSU because you got a decent amount of map here left still. You got to hold on. But that lead is over 100,000 points, so it's a decent place for them to be currently. Big combos across the board. Emla over 500, Cappy over 400, Fluzzlin over 400 as well, but it is Exarch with that 700 combo that finally does drop. Let's see if there's enough time left here for Shake Inc. to make a comeback, even with Fluzzlin and Exarch both breaking. That score is going to come down very rapidly if Cappy and Emla can both hold on here. Emla does break. Cappy has about a 550 combo, though, and it's only a 60,000, 70,000 point lead. However, there goes the break. And that is going to seal the deal. Another break point will occur. It will be Speedfrog taking a second break point in a row, taking a third point in a row. And they are opening this match up very, very hot. Coming in with 130,000 point victory on the second pick from Shake Inc. And with it, a 3-0 lead. Yep, they are feeling good. And I'm getting asked to ref this real quick, so I'm gonna go in the lobby and stuff. What? Alright. Well, I apologize to anyone watching this match for the typing sounds. I'm gonna just kind of do what I can here to help out for a moment while our referee takes care of whatever he's got going on. It's gonna be hidden three is the next pick, so the back-to-back hidden's coming in. Historia. Escucha el sonido de tu corazón. Amusingly, the Spanish title, but this is mapped by Musty, who is, of course, French. And our referee has returned. So, that is going to be it for me. There's the referee. Sorry. Hidden abuse time. Well, fortunately for Shake Inc., there's only two hidden picks even open because of the hidden two ban. So, not the end of the world for Shake Inc. Worst case scenario, they lose two hiddens and, you know, they kind of get going from there. So, 182 BPM, a cranky song. I feel it can kind of get a little bit of a feel for maps just from the artist in some cases. Cranky stuff tends to have bursts in finger control, sliders. Usually not too heavy under the aim. Micro aim, I guess you could say. Kind of that cursor awareness type of aim. More so than, you know, big mechanical jump aim. M-Law gonna continue to struggle in the hidden picks. Absolutely not his skill set, so this is kind of an unfortunate situation to come into for Shake Inc. But Cappy, a solid player on all mods, will try to carry him as best he can here, I think, even if M-Law continues to struggle, which he is going to so far. Cappy and Exarch, though, trading some misses. It's gonna be just, once again, Pleslin in the intro. Alright, so I was wrong. Pleslin's the hidden player, not Exarch. Exarch's just here for the ride. Are a lot of players having trouble with this map, actually. All four of them have broken a couple times. Exarch is, however, even with Cappy. Pleslin a bit ahead of M-Law, who is, again, struggling quite a bit. Already halfway through, about 120,000 point lead for Speed Frog. And they get a little bit of free time here with those slow sliders before we get into the back half of this map, which is, of course, going to decide the outcome. See how long these players can hold on. Well, that's a double break from Shake Inc. That's a full combo reset for them. That might have just ended it right there. Exarch does find a break, but Pleslin making his way through those curved sliders with Plum. Break from Cappy would really seal it, and there it is. So, don't think there's much to be said about this one, unfortunately. Exarch Pleslin just hidden abusing the two hidden picks they had available to them. Oh, God, Fuzz! Oh, my God! Oh, there he goes. There he goes. Oh, my. That did not go well for Pleslin, but it's still a 200,000 point win for Speed Frog. Oh, my goodness. You hate to see it. Wowie. Alright, well, Exarch did the heavy lifting there again, and it is a 4-0 lead now in favor of Speed Frog. First two picks are both teams going their way. That is a comfortable lead now for Speed Frog, 4-0. They've got quite a bit of wiggle room to play here. Question once again kind of just becomes, you know, what do you do here if you are Shake Inc? Do you have, you know, kind of the upside, right? Both of the Hiddens are now gone. There's no Hiddens left. Hidden 2 is banned. Hidden 1, Hidden 3 both picked. But you picked a couple maps that you probably felt pretty good about with Hard Rock 1, Freemod 2, lost them both. I think maybe you think about just going into the Nomad pool, maybe even into the DT pool, depending on how you feel about those double time picks. You know, you got to find something different at this point. Streams aren't working. Aim's not working. You know, do you think maybe we go alt? Maybe we go DT, you know, some double time, something different to break it up. You know, do you maybe go tech or something, right? You've got Nomad 4. We know Exarch doesn't like this Nomad 4. Problem is, I don't know that Emlon necessarily does either. I think Happy would be good at it, but hard to say for the rest. So it's a tricky spot to be in. If you are the team picking here, down that quick 0-4, I mean, only, what, about 50 minutes technically, but how much into the actual map are we, you know, about maybe 30 or so of that in terms of minutes, 30 minutes? Yeah, down 4-0 in that amount of time. It is going to be the Nomad 4. Emlaw is watching the stream right now. 100% Emlaw is watching the stream right now. he's actually ghosting. No, but that's kind of funny. So it is going to be the Tech Nomad pick. Sakura Burst, Shaw, Neil Perry, Ameth Riano, I believe, collab difficulty here. Yep, that is correct. And we have no audio? Audio? Well, while we hang out here, I'm gonna see audio. I checked this earlier and it was fine. Actually, just no MP3 in this folder. Okay. Wait, no, he started the... Okay. Okay, alright, hang on. Hang on. Okay, that sync is actually perfect. All right, we're good. I'm a genius. I'm a fucking genius. All right, it's perfect. It's perfect. I'm insane. Nobody realizes just what I'm doing currently. All right, this is a very, very tricky tech pick, by the way. This is really hard. Neil Perry, you know what to expect out of his stuff. I'm at Riano, likewise. Whenever they collab together, it's just gonna be slider hell. Emlaw though, 80% accuracy, but holding a 470 combo, giving a lead to Shake Inc. He's just missing every slider end and it doesn't matter. He's literally, I've never seen anyone cheese anything as hard as Emlaw is currently cheesing this map. This is the biggest cheese in the history of OSU tournament play, ladies and gentlemen. And it's working. They're actually ahead by 50,000 points. Also, I'm sorry if the audio is really loud. This should be a little better. Sorry about if that was insanely loud. Wow, I don't know what I'm watching, but Shake Inc. are winning by about 50,000 points here. One third, almost halfway through the map. Combo is pretty dead even, maybe slight advantage Speed Frog in terms of combo. But man, oh man, I don't know what I'm watching. I don't know if chat realizes what I'm doing, what I did just now, and the fact that it's working is hilarious. But man, Emla. Well, lowest combo now. But close enough that it doesn't really matter. It would take a complete disintegration here from Shake Inc. Oh, when there's a break from Fluzzlin in the slow part, that might have just given this one over to Shake Ink. No, Cappy finds a break as well. So just kidding. We've still got map to play here. About a third of the map still to come. This is pretty long. It's another 4 minute long pick. A lot of longer maps in this pool that are getting picked here early on. And it's all going to be just whether MLOK can keep up this cheese. He cannot. It's a break. Exarch with a 580 combo. Can he bring this one back for Speed Frog? That low accuracy for MLOK is going to be hurting him quite a bit. Low accuracy for really everyone, though, fortunately, for Shake Ink's sake. They're going to hold on to the lead for now. It's going to come down slowly but surely, but will it be fast enough? No, it will not. There's a break from Exarch. Cappy with the 230 combo. And somehow or other, Shake Ink are going to take this one, it looks like. And that's just a play of some sort. I don't know what sort, but it is a play of some sort. This is a certified Osu moment here at NADT. It's going to be Shake Ink taking their first point by almost 100,000 points, in fact. Which is a little mind-boggling when you consider the scores across the board, but Fluzzlin just not having a good time. And despite Exarch's best efforts, does put up the best score. Will not end up being enough here for Team Speed Frog. And Shake Ink on the back of whatever the heck that was that MLOK was doing, and the fact that Cappy ends up actually top scoring, I apologize. Exarch not top scoring, Cappy will be the top scorer. It's gonna do it here. Shake Ink are gonna put a point on the board by about 72,000 points. That was something to witness. So 4-1 goes the score. That's not actually the bans, but I don't know who made a bans command. I didn't even know there was one, so I haven't been updating it. I was hidden to DT4 from Shake Ink and Nomad 5 from Speed Frog. No, actually, I mean, it's not really that impressive. All I did was I went to YouTube and I opened up like a Monster Cat upload, or a Cypher Music, excuse me, upload of Sakura Bursts Sha. And it just happened to start at like the exact moment that the map started in the game. So it was just spot on. I didn't even have to adjust the timing at all. And we're just going to put on a little Monster Cat background music here because there's no audio in this while we're in between maps. But yeah, I tried to do that last week and it didn't work for the VTuber. But I tried to use the original version of the League of Legends song. I forget what it was offhand, but you know, if you were here, you remembered. Did not work. Anyway, enough about me. Shake Ink putting a point on the board finally on the tech pick, which I think kind of felt like a toss-up. Really, that was one where anybody could have won it. But Fluzzlin just not having a good time. That kind of made the difference. 72,000 points, and he was the lowest score by about 50,000 points. And Exarch putting up 260 against Cappy's 285. So, well done on that to Shake Ink. We'll see if they can build on that. Maybe need a little bit of momentum here. It is going to be the free mod 1 pick here, coming in from Speed Frog. Another OWC map. In fact, Lost Umbrella, PTSD difficulty. I have PTSD from this map, in fact, in the finals Nomad 3 slot. Which, imagine me just doing like air quotes around this being an alt pick. No, it was Takeover, which is a KDA song. It was the hidden last week that it was a VTuber cover of Takeover by KDA. Anyway, air quotes around this being an alt pick because it's like almost just like a high BPM aim map as much as anything else. The patterns are very snap aim focused. More so than kind of the flow aim that one would normally think of when they think of alt. So I think we're kind of blurring the lines between those two skill sets lately as players become more accustomed to alt. You have a lot of full alt players out there, so alt mapping does not really mean the same thing that it used to, where it was just flow aim, you know, Valo 108 stuff. So here we get an evil Elvis take on modern kind of snap flow aim. Very, very tricky map. We see finals, of course, coming to finals here, going from no mod into the free mod pool, which means we're going to again see several hiddens this time. It's going to be hidden on XR Plus and Cappy Hard Rock on MLaw only. Memory serves, we saw some very good performances on this pick in OWC, but unfortunately the players in this, I think, just a rung below those OWC guys. You know, no Vaxes here, no Fancy Lads in this particular match. So, you can expect the scores to be a little bit lower than you would have in OWC, especially when you add in the complexity of hidden or Hard Rock on this pick. You can kind of see why it's a linear aim, but there's some snap aim components to it as well, and some very tricky sliders. They just find players breaking everywhere. That was a really solid combo from Pleslin up over 500 before he finally did get that break, and it gave Speedfrog about a 50,000 point lead. We'll see what they can do. It's a combo advantage now in favor of Shake Inc. once again, but MLaw breaking means that will go away quickly. Again, a big combo here from Pleslin, proving to be a very, very good alt player and, you know, kind of this type of map player. He looked pretty good on this type of thing last week as well. You know, obviously a guy who has really, really strong aim, but I did not think of him when I thought of this skill set. He is proving quite an asset on maps like this. Another very big combo coming out from him here, over 450 to match, to back up that 500 combo he had earlier on. Really just outdoing everyone else in the lobby. Best accuracy as well. Skill set improvement, or skill cap improvement, I should say, from Pleslin has been very, very impressive to see over the past 2 months. He's developed a lot as a player. And XR both break, MLaw and Cappy follow up as well, though. So, into this last key eye, it's just going to be kind of a mere formality at this point here for Speedfrog, up by 100,000 plus points. They're just going to ride this one on home. Already established the big lead. That's all they needed to do. The two giant combos from Pleslin. He'll put up a near, if not 400k score. Let's see in this ending if he gets another few thousand points. He does. 400k, a really respectable score on this with hidden. I'm not gonna lie, that is very strong. Gonna keep going. This ending does not really butt up. And it is a very nearly 450,000 point score from Pleslin. Really, really strong performance from him, outdoing everyone else by a considerable margin. What a play. That is a 5-1 lead now for Speedfrog. They are just putting their foot on the gas pedal and not letting up one bit. Shake Inc. falling pretty far behind now. And what do you kind of do for your picks if you are Shake Inc. here? It's a tough spot to be in. They were victorious on the Tech Nomad, but I don't know that there's anything else in the pool that they can really feel like that about. Again, maps like that, really not widespread in this pool. Do you maybe go back to Hard Rock? You know, you've got the Hard Rock 2 and Hard Rock 3s available. Remod 3 available. I don't know. I'm not really sure where you go now as Shake Inc. I think anything they pick is going to surprise me to some extent.
Huh?
We don't want six. All right, so they're just gonna lean into the awkward map skill set, I guess. Nomad 6 is Deal with the Devil, the Gambling Maniac difficulty. This is mapped by Mikan. And I'm going to be honest here and say that I don't know anything about this map. Well, this diff of this map, I guess, is more accurate. So we're gonna go with a little bit of a sight read here, basically, for me. And, Emma's still playing the previous map. Into it we go. This gonna be some awkward slider hell? Well, it sure looks like it is. Four players holding about 200 combo before Cappy does find a break. And the advantage in favor of Speed Frog. I'm the lead with the double FC still alive. We'll see how far they can carry it. It's another very long map. 4 minutes and 38 seconds. It'd be like hashtag WYD, man. Why is this pool so long compared to the previous ones? Let's see how things go here for Team Speed Frog. They've got a double FC still intact. Meanwhile, Emlaw a bit behind and Cappy trying to build back up after his earlier miss. There goes Fleslin. That is the first break for Speed Frog. XRX still holding on, but the double combo from Shake Inc. gonna bring this score gap back. 50,000, 60,000 point lead. There's a break from Emlaw. So XRX versus Cappy for combos now. Both hold on through some very fast sliders. XRX with pretty solid accuracy as well, 98%. Really, really impressive actually on a map like this, but he does find a slider break. So now it is Cappy with that big combo, and Fleslin did not actually break earlier when I thought he did. Thank you, tournament client. But so that means he is still in the lead. Speed Frog gonna be feeling not too terrible. Cappy with about a 670 combo. There is a break from Fleslin, I believe, but Cappy matches it. Assuming those were all misses, it's gonna be three breaks, just XR holding combo through that portion of the map. About halfway through the pick here. 120,000 points to the good for Speed Frog. Not feel like the sort of map is ever going to let up on you, so you got to be on your guard at all times. You can't make any silly mistakes. The break from Fleslin. There's a bit of combo on the side of Shake Inc., but Exarch with 450 really kind of putting them to shame. Another very tough, quick slider section. Exarch holding through just fine. And there go Emlaw and Cappy both. Exarch nearly at 98%. Best accuracy in the lobby by 2%. That is very good. This is kind of one of those matches where it's just more well-rounded players kind of end up winning. Exarch, with all his experience in all these tournaments over all kinds of different maps, has become a player who is really talented in a wide variety of areas. You know, Fleslin has looked really good so far this match, but this type of map just feels like it is kind of much more in Exarch's favor than anyone else. Based on the performance, it seems to be an accurate assessment. Many breaks in the drum solo. Bass solo coming in as well. Some more breaks. Every instrument getting its turn here. The guitar solo now. And everybody holding through that portion, so So I'm basically over. 200,000 point lead in favor of Speed Frog. Combo lead on their side. Accuracy lead on their side. Exarch on their side. And we'll go into the last quarter of the map with Speed Frog looking to bring this one on home. Find themselves a 6-1 lead. I mean, what can you say? They just look plain better on basically everything. Cappy gets slow slided, and it's just going to be too little too late no matter what now. Imla finding a break, and that is full-on combo reset. Both players on Speed Frog just far ahead of their opposition. Looking absolutely dominant. 200,000 plus points. When the scores overall are this relatively low is actually a pretty big lead. And into the ending we come with Speed Frog. Set themselves up with quite a few match points. 6-1 now the score, and their own pick next to try and close this thing out and move on. Feels like a formality now. Well, it's not GG yet. Best of 13. Quite GG. Finals week. Finals week is best of 13. He said GG's. They both said GG's, but they both know it's best of 13. All right, well. Maybe Cappy didn't actually know. I'm not sure anymore. Well, it's the pick to come from Speed Frog, and they're gonna probably close this thing out here based on the way they've been playing compared to their opponents so far, but there's always a chance. What's the shortest map in the pool that is still remaining? DT2 or DT3, I guess? No one one's actually, like, relatively short. A lot of these picks pretty long this week, as I said. I just want Booga Booga Choo Choo because I think it would be funny. No, it's going to be DT1, of course. Got to pick the longest of the DTs. Anne, Nina, Ombre, Twilight, mapped by Lassie. A ranked single diff set. 10.3, CS 4.4, pretty long. Lowish BPM sounding, but it's actually 263 with DT. This is actually a... Wait. Right? Yeah, I guess it is. Okay. Didn't look right. I don't know why. 263 BPM. Pretty speedy, even though, like, it sounds just like this slow zone. DT, possibly only DT. Just kidding, we might be doing Nomad 1. Alright, so it's actually gonna be Nomad 1. Alright, we're Nomad 1 gaming, it's gonna be some 2U. 225 BPM Nomad 1. So, a little bit higher in terms of BPM than your average Nomad 1 would be. But, yeah, 2U maps are all this BPM, I feel like. There's no 2U maps that are slow, seems like.
I'm not the one who's running out of time.
So, in we go, Nomad 1. Possibly the last pick of the match. Shake ain't coping. It's not, for their sake. Trying to avoid elimination here. Go home in that 5th, 6th slot. We'll see how everybody feels on just, you know, kind of some plain Jane aim. I think the most difficult part about this is just the BPM. As long as you're okay with 225, you'll be alright. But there are players for whom that is pretty difficult. A lot of single tappers in this one. Looks like the only player actually alternating this is Fuzzlin. So everybody feeling fine with the BPM. No breaks as of yet, almost 500 combo in. Yet to see a miss from any player. Accuracy lead in favor of Shake Inc. Emil on the SS, Cappy. I believe that's two 100s, maybe three. It's really just going to be all about who breaks somewhere. A lot of good aim from these four players. Everybody very comfortable in the Nomad 1 skill set. Exarch and Emil are going to trade. So Emil now, I believe, zero 100s, one miss. Exarch, a couple more hundreds and one miss. A little bit of combo lead in favor of Shaking now as Exarch finds another break, but it's Cappy versus Fuzzlin. Both looking really, really strong. And there goes Cappy, so it's all in Fuzzlin. Now let's see how long he can hold on to this big FC. He's going to be able to keep the lead in favor of Speed Frog for the moment. And there is the FC through that difficult portion. Emil with about a 230 combo, about 30 combo ahead of Exarch. But Fuzzlin with the FC building up all the advantage in the world for Speed Frog. Not anymore, though. He broke before it was safe. That was not where he wanted to miss at all. So it's about a 70,000 point lead for Speed Frog. But small combo advantage now in favor of Shake Inc. There is time on the clock. We can absolutely bring this one back. Can Shake Inc. in the last Ki? All they have to do is hold on to their combos. Score gap will come back. All eyes on that Emla and Cappy raw aim. See how they can do. No breaks. It's coming down. Only about 35,000 points and shrinking. Shake Inc. making a run at this one in the last seconds. It's all going to depend on whether or not there's enough time. It's going to happen if there's enough time. Are there enough notes left in the map? Oh, it's a break from Cappy. Well, now there aren't enough notes left in the map. Wait, Exarch breaks as well. Oh, there goes Fleslin. And Emla breaks too. It would have been the chance right there for Shake Inc. Emlot just needed to hold another 20 combo, but he could not do it, and that is going to be it for Shake Inc. Speed Frog, take the victory by the score of 7-2-1. Well done to them, a very good performance over the course of this entire match. Very, very strong performance from the team of Exarch and Fleslin. They will advance onward into the loser's bracket round 7. They'll face off against the winners of Midnight Snow versus Leebs, that is Utami and TJ versus Headstack and Mode. Four players that I don't really know that I expected to be talking about this deep into the tournament, but they have performed very well and have gotten this far. We'll have a shot at that top 3. Exarch and Fleslin flexing their muscle. Just looking so good on so many different types of skills. It looks like we are gonna get a little bit of tiebreaker here. We're gonna watch a little tiebreaker before we go for the night. I don't know if we're gonna expect any tiebreakers in any of these matches. We honestly, if there's gonna be a tiebreaker, I would think maybe Midnight Snow versus Leibs, or maybe that winner of the, you know, the loser's bracket potential match would be another option. Cool to see a tiebreaker. You always like seeing a tiebreaker. We're gonna hang out, watch them play this for a few minutes. It's a pretty decently long tiebreaker. 7 minutes, or excuse me, 6 minutes, 17 seconds. Hidden Hard Rock from XR, gonna set a pretty big PP play. Let's take a look here on this one. Hidden Hard Rock. In Hard Rock, 98% accuracy would be 838 PP, so rooting for you there, Exarch, but it's already not going to happen. Yeah, that was a match. I don't know. I think, the skill sets just didn't really match up super well for Emlon Cappy, unfortunately. You know, they kind of made it through those early matches thanks to being able to kind of brute force their way through their opponents. But once they got to some players who were a little more well-rounded, fortunately just not quite able to hang on kind of the hidden picks, the gimmicky picks against more well-rounded types of players. Unlucky kind of matchups for them too in that regard, running into Fantasy Lad and Aryu, who are two incredibly well-rounded players, and then Exarch and Fluzzle, who just played really well this match, and likewise were able to lean into selections that were very good for them. This is where we're going to get to see kind of that skill cap of Shake Inc. You can see how well they're playing on this tiebreaker. This is the type of map that would have been much more in their favor. That's why the teams are banning out the Nomad 2, Nomad 5 combo against them. Good aim players, good stream players, very quick. But, wasn't enough when you can ban out kind of their primary advantage over you. So, not a whole lot to talk about here, as we said. Just kind of a tiebreaker showcase. We already have the result of our match in. It was a resounding one-sided victory for Speed Frog. We can look ahead, you know, to tomorrow. Our three matches. Well, two of them are now set. One of them is half set. We've got White Cat, Insulet Area versus Unnation, Fire Rage, BTMC, which, you know, again, you look at the skill sets of those teams and you kind of see, you know, kind of certain things that they're stronger on in most cases. You know, White Cat, obviously Fancy Lad is going to just do ridiculously well on anything skill cap. That guy is an unbelievable performer on things like the tech maps, on, you know, alt maps, on reading. He can do it all. Aryu, likewise. I think if there's any point of contention, you know, Unnation, I think arguably a better kind of a Nomad 2 team. I think Fiery BTMC, obviously known for being very good at streams. Very good aim players as well, you know, things like Nomad 1. I think you could honestly see Fancy Lad Aryu banning out Nomad 1, Nomad 2, or Nomad 1, Nomad 5, Nomad 2, Nomad 5, some combination thereof. I think where Aryu Fancylad have the advantage is kind of going to be the hidden. It's going to be the more awkward picks because Fiery is very good at those. Beast Troll is not as good at those, I would say. He has been working very hard over the past year, year and a half at improving those skill sets. Ed is always one to continue grinding, and you know how much better he's gotten to the point where he's in for things like low AR hiddens for USA and, you know, things like that. But I think still lagging a bit behind the others on those types of picks, so Fancylad Aryu probably going to look into those types of maps. You know, you might see things like... Actually, you did see Fiery and BTMC both getting towards the top of the leaderboard on Nomad 4, so they might leave that up. They are both good tech players, but I think Fiery a bit more than BTMC. But I think some of the gimmicky type stuff will be in favor of Team White Cat. I think some of the more mechanics-based stuff maybe in favor of Unnation. A lot of maps just real toss-ups in that matchup. Both teams very good at a lot of the types of picks. So I think that one... I think I'm excited for it. I think it's going to be a very close matchup. I think there are two teams, obviously four players that are incredibly talented, four OWC players, all champions in the OWC that just ended. So you know their pedigree is incredibly high. Some of the best tournament players in the world and the most competitive region, the most competitive country in the world for tournament play. You're going to see, I think, some very good performances in that match. I think that one could, strictly speaking, go either way. We will see who kind of comes to play, you know, who is really best prepared for the match. But that is one you're not going to want to miss. That is going to be 2 UTC Monday, so that is, of course, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 6 p.m. Pacific if you're out on the West Coast. Tune in for some dinner time OC if you're out there as we watch MLOD just absolutely crushing this map. This is why you ban this type of thing against this team, because my lord is he popping off right now. That was a really fucking good play from MLOD. What? 2K combo, 99.27 ACK? Alright, bud. That'll cap off the match. In style. Midnight Soul versus Leebs. I think Midnight Soul just outskills Leebs at this point. I think Headstack and Mode, I don't know that their skill cap really holds up on a finals pool. And TJ and Utami have both been looking really, really good in the tournament. So... not as much to talk about on that one because they're players that I'm not quite as familiar with. You know, they had the 6-4 match last week for Midnight Stowe that they lost to Fiery and BTMC. Leebs 6-0 victory over Team Washington, and then 6-3 over Team Sljivovica. So that'd be Verderix and Fudu in the first match, Zudinator and Kyle in the second match. A little bit surprised to see them winning these matches, but I think beneficiaries of a little bit of an easier bracket, you know, just by virtue of being in the loser's bracket, you typically will get teams that aren't as strong because they've lost. It's just kind of what happens. So I don't know that I'm necessarily sold on the strength of Leaves. They can absolutely prove me wrong, but I just don't know how well they're going to scale compared to a team, you know, like those, the two teams in the winner's bracket and a couple of these other teams in the winner's bracket as well. I'll be interested to see them play. Obviously, Headstack has been looking really good. I think Mode has definitely outperformed expectations of him. But I think definitely Midnight Snow going to be the ones favored in that one. But again, you know, the pool is pretty varied. There's a lot of different types of maps in it. And so I think all those things combine to make for some very good matches, often better matches than one might expect going into them. So we're going to have some good matchups tomorrow. 22 UTC, that is 5 p.m. Eastern Time, 2 p.m. Pacific Time. First match of the day, Midnight Snow versus Leebs. 1 UTC, our loser's bracket potential match. It'll be the winner of that match versus Speed Frog, who just saw victorious over Shake Inc. That'll be at 1 UTC Monday, and then 2 UTC following it up. Team White Cat versus the Unnation as the late match. That'll be the winner's bracket final. One of those teams guaranteed a top 2 spot now in this tournament. So it's going to be an exciting Sunday here, and I hope everybody sticks around for those matches tomorrow afternoon and evening. Hope you guys enjoyed the match tonight. Good job to Speed Frog, really looking very strong. I think making a good case for themselves as a potential top 3 team if they can find a win tomorrow in that loser's bracket match. Jake Inc. will be headed home 5th-6th in the tournament, running into two very formidable opponents. Nothing to be ashamed of there. But well done to Speed Frog. GG's to both teams. Thank you all for watching. I've been this one guy. And it's been a pleasure as always. We will see you guys tomorrow afternoon for the second to last Sunday here in North America Duo Tournament. Have a great night.